What up, though? How y'all doing out there? This is the first day since coronavirus that I've been live-ish.
Can you hear me?
I'm broadcasting from the couch in my living room in Los Feliz, California. John is down in, like, the shitty part of Koreatown.
That's correct.
No one's accusing you of being in the nice part of Koreatown, let's be real. You're in the shit part of Koreatown. And we're here to cheer you guys up. It's gonna be look. It's gonna be a bit hard. I'm telling you right now, we're trying our best, but you know me, I'm like Mr. Keep It Real. And right now I really feel annoyed by this whole fucking situation. So, we're working on getting calls. We can't do calls yet, which this show is caller driven, as you well know. We have some of the best callers. I say we got the best callers in radio. No one beats our callers, and we have been robbed of that by. What's going on with that music back there? You guys going up and down on that shit.
Oh, sorry. That was me screwing around.
Why don't you figure the fuck out? It's distracted.
Sorry.
Hey, just can't help myself. Just wanted to, no one said hi to me yet, so I just wanted to play with this music till you notice me.
All these new toys.
Do you like this shit, John? Do you like fucking... You seem like... I'm annoyed by us having to do the fucking show out of our rooms, and you're like, oh, we got new toys. I got this great little microphone. It's like, ugh.
I got stuff to learn. It's interesting.
You like the new mics. Give me the goddamn old fucking thing. There's literally no one in the studio, and they won't let us go in the studio and talk.
Yeah, I went down there. I probably shouldn't talk too much about that, but
because God forbid, yeah. You know, I get fucking CV, and then I'm laid up. At one point, one has to ask himself: is the cure worse than the fucking disease? And I'm starting to feel my answer is yes. So far, that's how I feel. Only time will tell, but I'm saying a resounding yes.
Well, from what I can tell, you don't want this. You don't.
What's
want
that?
You don't want to find yourself with coronavirus. It looks pretty bad. Depending on who gets it, but
well, that's what I'm saying. Depending on who gets it,
yeah.
They only do tests on people that have it really bad. There's a bunch of people that don't have it really bad that they don't do tests on. So they don't even have positives. So it can be really bad for some people, and it can be mild for other people.
To get a test, it seems to help if you've got a lot of money, cash on hand.
That or like you got like crazy symptoms, you're an extreme case. So I guess that's my whole point. So there might be all this CV that is not that bad, but since it's not that bad, you're not getting a test. So therefore, the CV that is showing, they're like, oh, it's fucking awful. The cases are going up. Well, more tests are being administered. Of course, the cases are going up. Fucking ridiculous. So I'm none too happy about all of this. I'd much rather put on clothes. Right now, I'm doing the show from my robe on a couch. I'd much rather put on clothes, go to work, talk some shit to y'all, hear how you guys are doing. Hopefully you're doing well. If you got it, hopefully you feel better. Maybe you know someone's got it. Hopefully they feel better. Maybe you know someone's got it. It's not that bad. We'll never know because we can't talk to you. We can't take phone calls. I sure am glad we sent all of our jobs over to China. It really seemed to work out for the best for us. Thanks for the last 30 years. Appreciate that. Fucking awesome. And we're all responsible for it. Everybody got their shoes for cheaper and got that third TV you didn't need because it was cheaper. Because it was made in fucking China. There you go. Congratulations. Pat yourself on the back. We have weakened ourselves as a country so that you can buy cheap shit. Bam. Let me drink some of this. I got instant coffee. I'm drinking instant coffee. Oh, it tastes
instant
like shit.
Coffee?
Yeah, man, I can't. I didn't have time. I was like, let me fucking... I had to grind beans and shit. Then I just saw some Nescafe. I was like, yeah, I'll just do Nescafe.
Man, Nescafe.
It tastes like burning.
Yeah. I think I've had that since college.
Yeah, whatever. It's just all about getting the... You know what I did while we were down? I went and did acid and mushrooms and ecstasy. Fucking walked around and was like, fuck this shit.
You were out there on the streets?
Yeah, I was out there cruising, faded as fuck, yeah. Yeah, it was awesome.
That didn't sort of freak you out more?
You gotta go out there and take a walk. What's that?
I mean, that didn't sort of, you didn't get caught up in your thoughts, walking around completely high, worrying about that stuff, or was it a release?
I'm more afraid of our government than I am of this virus. So, no. No, I'm
yeah, not,
not. I didn't get freaked out.
Not that long ago, I would have disagreed with you. Not that long ago, I would have disagreed with you, but the things that are coming down now are a little strange, even for me.
Yeah, man, they're going fucking bananas, dog, and they're like, oh, it's for your own safety. At the end of the day, it's just like, you know what? You know, at a certain degree, we got to sacrifice our safety for some freedom. Got some freedom up in this bitch. There's many people who disagree with me right now, and they're muttering at their radios, you're gonna get everybody's thing. And like, look, man, if you're going through it, and speedy recovery to you, man. That, you know, I was in Michigan, and my family called me up, and they were like, you got to get out of there, you're gonna fucking get mom sick. So I just had to leave Michigan. I was just like, that fucking sucks. So now I'm back here, and I understood, she's old, she's more susceptible to getting that shit, so like fine, whatever. If I got her sick, I'd never hear the fucking end of it. So I was just like, all right, dude, let me get the fuck out of here. Even though she was around more people than I was. I'm going to put on some of my fucking hand sanitizer.
Do you have a stockpile?
I got some from... I got CBD hand sanitizer. And then they were like complaining about the price. Because I was like, hey, I got the plug on this shit.
And they're like, it's $15.
I'm like, well, go buy some somewhere else. How much does it cost? Oh, you can't get any. Suck my fucking dick, asshole. Plus, it's got CBD in there, so it kills more things. It doesn't calm me down at all. This CBD does nothing, but it just helps with killing more germs.
Does it really? Where are you getting that?
Yeah, look it up. Look it up. Off the fucking on a website.
CBD.
CNN told me. MSNBC told me, John. I heard from Rachel Maddow. I was watching Rachel Maddow. She was like, "By the way, CBD kills germs." I was like, "Word."
Nice.
I'm on it. Yep. I knew it. Yeah. You're like, "Oh, really?" That's it. That's all. What have you been doing with your? What have you been doing with your fucking time?
Well, not a hell of a lot. Can't go to the bar anymore, which kind of sucks. But you know, I've been getting the show on the air.
You've been saving the day. And, there was a bunch of shows that was allegedly done, and none of them were fucking done. And John has single-handedly saved the day. So,
those are.
And like, look, we haven't figured this whole thing out yet, so we're gonna do our best for y'all. We really are. Like, today we're doing this. We'll do a news, and then we're gonna run like a best of. Do you know what the best of we're gonna pull?
Well, it is Thursday. I mean, I could.
Oh, it's pill mix. So there you go. We're going to run a pill mix. See, I didn't even know what fucking day it is today. That's like, yeah, it's all a blur.
Come up for air. Come on.
Come up for air, dude. For what? Like I don't know. I don't know what fucking day it is. They're like, you can't leave the house. You can't do this. You can't do that. You can't go. And then I get criticized for losing track of fucking days. Like, okay, sorry. Sorry, you've turned me into a fucking hermit, but, like, I lost track of days. My bad. So, yeah, we got this, we got the news, we got the pill mix. Tomorrow we'll do a Feel Good Friday. We'll rerun a Feel Good Friday before this pandemic, this scamdemic fucking hits. People are going to be...
He's not taking it serious enough.
There's enough people on here that's taking it way more serious than me. So there you go. You got them to go to if you want to live in perpetual fear. I'm just like, hey, if you're old, stay your ass at home. And if you're young... Did any of those youngsters that went on the spring break, they were like, ah, fuck that, and then they all got fucking the Wuhan shit. Did any of them die? Or
as far as I know, no one's died yet, but I think it's like
exactly
3 people.
Nope. Yeah. Nope. Didn't die, did they? Nope.
Well,
They didn't report that part. No deaths. From that.
Oh, wow. 44 Texas students coronavirus after spring break trip.
How many deaths?
Right now, none as far as I can tell.
Not bad. That's what they need. That's what they need to be fucking. That's what they need to be reporting. 0 deaths out of 44. Not bad. And make those motherfuckers go lay their ass down.
Well, one could argue that they're spreading it to grandma and grandpa.
Well, that's between them and their grandparents, ain't it?
Conceivably.
That's why I had to leave my crib, because I didn't want to get my mom sick. So I was like, all right, let me get out over here so I don't get my fucking old folks sick. Shit is real for old people. But, you know. Stress will kill you, y'all. Don't be afraid. Just be calm. We'll get through this. That's all I'm saying. Be calm. We'll get through this together. And we got the pill mix, everything. Give you some normalcy. Didn't they want us to say that we weren't? Like doing it from the house or some shit like that.
Oh, I've seen notes from everybody. Everyone has an opinion.
Fuck
but that
out
was
of here, dude.
It's kind of hard to hide it.
They're like, oh, we got to give them normalcy. Except for it's not normal. I'm like, well, I keep it real. So I'm telling you I'm doing it from my fucking house. And I can't wait for them to let me do it from... Once I start doing it from serious, then you guys can be like, oh, shit's getting a little bit better. But right now, shit's not getting better. I'm doing it from the fucking house. Proof that we're fucked. Proof we're fucked. Judy's
we're
doing
fucked.
It from the motherfucker.
Is it?
I was hitting up some girls. I was like, hey, you want some Corona dick? And they're like, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Yep. Been fucking. Been getting some pussy. Going.
Are you serious?
Treating this. Yeah. People hate me. I'm like, I'm doing everything I'm not supposed to do. Fuck them. I'll do whatever I want.
You're just going to make me longer.
And the women are coming over. Are you going to their place? Or are they coming to yours?
They're coming to my place.
Wow.
I spray their pussy with Lysol before I eat it. It's real.
Right. Nice.
I got that medical grade Lysol, the linen scent. Shh. Spray them all down. And I eat their asshole.
Wow, no fear over there. No fear at all.
If it's my time to go, it's my time to go, bro. I'm not fucking... I want to lead a life worth living. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to be over here fucking holed up in my goddamn thing watching. I watch all of the fucking Tiger King shit like everybody else. That Carol lady's a bitch. Fuck that Carol lady. Fuck her.
Guilty.
And I don't want to be a spoiler alert. She's got some shady shit attached to her ex-husband, but even if she didn't have that, this bitch is going over to other people's fucking tiger places, getting money, got people working for free, and then fucking taking those tigers, getting money for them, and then putting them in her shitty fucking thing. She's just a piece of shit all around. Fuck her, dog. She's not a good person. Don't like her at all.
It was kind of hard to tell the difference. It was kind of hard to tell the difference between what she was doing and what the people that she was criticizing happened to be doing. I mean, she was condemning them, and then yet when they put the camera on her, it's like, well, what's she doing differently? It seemed like the
nothing.
Same kind of...
Yeah, I know. Nothing. Yeah, she's just saying, I'm not profiting off of them. This is a non-profit. But that doesn't mean you're not making money off of them. A nonprofit just means it doesn't report profits at the end of the year. I'm sure her salary is quite big. I'm sure she's doing okay from this shit. And her fucking Carol shit looked jankier than half the fucking people shit did. And I'm not saying that there's not some assholes out there that be treating their tigers bad and stuff like that. And, you know, shit. I've been into some like... some fucking low-end drug dealers' houses where they got, like, a fucking alligator in the basement, you know, just in some fucking...
Jeez.
With, like, two boards holding it in and like, half of, like, filled with water. It looks dank as fuck. Like, this is not ideal. I'm, you know, like, I'm sure there's some situations where those animals need some rescuing, but I don't think all of those tigers that she so-called rescued were coming from places that were any worse than where she ended up with them. And she ended up making money off of them. So fuck her. Fuck her bitch made ass husband. Oh, fucking fuck boy getting pegged ass bitch. And then,
yeah, even I laughed at that guy and his life, but... Hey, they're balling pretty hard. They're making a lot of money for a nonprofit, so something's going right.
Yeah, they're fucking they're preying on people's emotions. People are emotional, man. That's what they do. That's what these nonprofits do. They show you some all they need to do to make some money is just show like a crying baby or a fucking, you know, a beat up, you know, a roughed up cub, and then you're like, oh, how can I help? I feel, throw some money. And they throw all that money at them. They play all kinds of emotions.
Oh, yeah. I've worked for a nonprofit, a couple, and then suddenly I find out that the person running it's making $100,000. I was like, what? You're making $100,000?
Oh, yeah. That's like I was on a date with some chick from a nonprofit. She was working down in South Central. She was so proud of herself. She was like, yeah, I work at a nonprofit, and we're doing, like, outreach to, you know, people in the neighborhoods. And we even hire people within the neighborhood to do the outreach. And I was like, who ends up doing better with the outreach? I knew the answer. The people in the neighborhood cats are going to do better talking to other neighborhood cats because you trust that, you know, like they're speaking their language, they're from the same background, they trust them. So it's these neighborhood cats end up doing better. And in the outreach program, guess who gets paid less? The neighborhood cats, because they don't have a fucking college degree. I'm like, this is just as fucking, this is, you're marginalizing these people just like you say you're fighting against the marginalization of these people. She's like, well, we got to pay fucking college. We got to pay our college loans. I was like, no one told your dumbass to go to college. I didn't get to fuck her after that, but
it's shocking.
I didn't want to either. I was like, fuck this dumb bitch. Yeah. I'm very wary of nonprofits. It's usually some underhanded shit. Half the time, 50% of the time, it's some underhanded shit. And that Carol lady, fuck her, dog. Fuck her.
You think she did it?
With her husband?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I think she did it. But it doesn't even matter. Like, I think the other shit that she's doing is fucking grimy, too. Like, everything about this bitch is a piece of shit. Now, you know, the gay method, he isn't like, he's a gay method, you know what I mean? It's not like this guy's flawless, you know, but he's got his own issues, but he's no Carol. Carol's a cunt. Fuck her. I don't like her. So we're going to do the news, and then we are going to do the pill mix. And people, please be patient with us as we work through this. We're just trying to find the best way to get you guys new shows as we are, as we're all going through this and everything's changing day to day. And we're just doing the best we can, so be patient with us. I might be a little cranky the first couple shows, but I'm sure I'll turn it all around and stop harping on the fact that I think this is bullshit, and just try to cheer you guys up. I'd like to thank, is it Dan that's helping us out in Minnesota?
That is correct.
Dan in Minnesota, Dan is helping us connect. Thanks to Dan in Minnesota, Dan, for getting us on air. Both me and John are just each, we're both each holed up in our house just trying to get you guys the best shows possible. So they're not going to be as, I'll tell you right now, they're not going to be on par with what we usually do, but this is as good as it gets right now. This is like when parents get divorced and shit, and we're just trying to do the best we can. We're just trying to make a good Christmas for you. And you're like, it's not as good as last Christmas. We're like, we know it's not. We're trying our best. So news is coming up next. After that, we got the pill mix. And tomorrow is Friday, so there's that. All right, don't go anywhere. It is the All Out Show.
And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
All right. right, so through one of these female-centered websites I go to for some bizarre reason, Refinery29, they're asking the question, is penis size genetic? Where does your penis size come
yes.
from?
Yes.
That is in fact true.
Is it, and it everything's looks like, genetic. Isn't that kind of the deal?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's...
They actually pay money to do a fucking... To see if shit was genetic?
Yeah, and they pay this lady, Elizabeth Gugliano, to write this piece. It looks like penises get most of their genetic material from the mother's side.
From the mom's side of the family.
Mm-hmm. So do you know anything about your mom's relatives and their penis sizes?
I don't know anything about that. I only know Angelini's side.
You've never seen your dad's penis?
Well, that's not my mom's side.
Oh, sorry. Right.
So yeah, I've seen Ange was shameless. He'd walk around butt naked all the fucking time. He ain't gave a fuck. He's walking around naked all the time. Ange had a bat. Yeah. So maybe I got some of my shit from my mom, but I don't got a bat, but it's not awful either. It's just like, yeah, not bad.
Standard?
Yeah, they'd be like, yeah, not bad. That's all right.
And they do have this qualifier here, though, that if a father has a bigger penis, the sons will probably be in similar length. So if your dad is really rocking it, then there's a distinct possibility you're in good shape.
So it goes to the mother unless your dad just has a bat, and then you'll get a touch of the bat. T-O-B.
The odds are in your favor.
Yo, for people used to think I was crazy because I was like practicing like genetic engineering and shit, and I didn't want to fuck with no Asian broads because I didn't want my son to have a small dick,
right?
And they're like, you can't say that. I'm like, man, go to China. That shit, or go to one of them Korean spas if you ever want to feel good about your dick. Not all of them cats got little dicks, but you don't see a ton. There's a reason why you don't see a ton of fucking Asian porn stars. It's not discrimination, you know?
Now, I can never get into it either when I try to watch Asian porn for some reason. I don't know. Everyone just seems so timid.
I don't got that bat. Plus, they be doing that weird outside-the-mouth kissing. You ever notice that shit? Where they, like, they do the, like, they're eating out air and shit. And the other person will be, you be like, what the fuck is that? Like, who likes that? The shit looks slimy.
There's a lot of licking.
Yeah, man. Yeah, shit's genetic.
And
most
they do
it is.
Here that this is something that you've warned about in the past, but during this animal study, when the guy is in the womb, if levels of hormones known as androgens are low, as the fetus grows, penis length could be stunted, and exposure to other toxins, including like these phthalates we've talked about, that can fuck up your penis size.
So, really?
Oh, yeah.
What are androgens?
It's a hormone. I can find out where you get that. But it seems
thanks.
Like...
Thanks for telling me what something. Right. It's a hormone. What the fuck does that mean, man?
It means it's
our
tip.
First day back in like a year. Right. We're a little rusty. Give us a break.
Androgens. Avoid those.
Yep. Thanks, John. Way to just fucking throw out word salad at me and not be able to fucking back it up. Typical. Let's just move on. I'll look up. Right. And Chris ain't even here to look up this shit. Y'all don't even understand what we're trying to do for y'all. Are you in your room? In your sad room?
You know, exactly.
You're in your sad ass room. I'm in my fucking living room in a robe, drinking coffee, just like, psh. We tried to get into the building, y'all. We did. We tried. It just didn't work out. They were like, nah, fuck you. Can't get in the building.
I'm still working on it. I never did know. It seems hard, but I'm not giving up.
We got Dan in Minnesota trying to help us out. We're actively trying to get Dan out of a job just because we're like,
no.
It's nothing. It's not you, Dan. It's us. Shout out to Dan in Minnesota. Give me another goddamn news article.
All right. But so since we're both working from home and you don't have this, I've got one sitting here, but the Amazon Alexa, of course, some lawyers are warning people, turn that shit off when you're talking about your cases. Because it will just accidentally, not accidentally, but there have been some studies where it just starts recording 19 times a day at least, just out of nowhere.
I went to a plug's house and I could not believe that he had that shit. I'm like, bro.
I know.
Like, I gotta get on all these different fucking, like, all these different ways to talk to you. You know, they got all these different, like, devices that make text disappear and shit, Signal and Wicker and all. You know, you got to use all these fucking different devices to talk to motherfuckers. Then you go to pick up and he's got like a fucking Alexa right there. I'm like, and the Ring. I'm like, bro, you're bugging your fucking house. We went through all of that shit and you're at the end of the day, you're bugging your house. Like, this is fucking ridiculous.
It's very real. You walk in and then suddenly say, hey, Jude, how many do you want? And then somebody somewhere at one of their facilities just like, hey, this guy Jude, he likes this and this. And then,
yeah.
I mean, people are listening.
That guy wanted mushrooms. That's crazy. You know what I mean? Fucking nuts.
And they start bouncing around the office and then someone says, hey, that's Jude from the radio. And then, hey. But really, the attorneys are taking this very seriously and they're just... I mean, you know, we joke about it, but these are people dealing with very serious topics, and
I don't joke about it. I'm dead serious. You joke about it. I'm serious about it. I'm like, yo, bro, they're fucking bugging you, man. They're fucking bugging you. It's over. You think it's a joke? I don't think it's a joke. I'm like, yo, dog, they bugging you. They don't play. They're not playing. Even right now, they're probably listening to me. They're probably listening to me saying they're bugging me, and they're gonna try to sell me some bug or some shit on Amazon. It'll come up.
Well, so you want to? There's a lady I know. She's got one in her room. She's got one in the living room. She's got one in the bathroom, so she can start pulling up her favorite songs in the shower.
Yeah, they know she jerks off to and shit. They know all of her dirty secrets. When she comes, all of that shit. They got it all. Ugh. They know everything.
Yeah, and this article, they even point out here that even the word congresswoman has been known to activate the device. So you can just say these random things and then accidentally just starts recording. So take it seriously.
Yeah. Damn, that shows you how tied up to the government they are. Like, if you just say congresswoman, they're like, boop, what? What did you say? What? Say that again. Record.
That's crazy. That is crazy.
Fucking nuts, man. As we're like being quarantined in a house in this dystopian fucking present, I cannot believe this shit right now. Like, I'm trying to keep like a smile on my face. They're like, they need you now more than ever. To be like, what? To tell you it's fucking over? Like, this is ridiculous, dog. This is fucking a wrap. That's my message to you. Fucking over. This is crazy.
These are the end times. No, they're not. Come on.
We'll get through this shit.
So TikTok. I don't know if you've got the TikTok account. I think you do, but
not now.
Really? At this point, you don't have a TikTok even to check out these young ladies or something?
Nah, man, that's China.
it is China, by the way.
Yeah, it's China, bro. Y'all motherfuckers are idiots. Like, China hates you, man. Like, China hates us. Can't you get that through your fucking greasy head? China fucking hates us, man. Everything they do is to, like, they're competing with us globally. So, like, why? That I've already given them enough of my information. I'm not going to give them any more willfully. So, all right, what about TikTok?
All right, so TikTok, the Chinese video sharing app, they instructed moderators, the people who sort of run how all these things show up on your phone, they instructed these people to suppress posts created by people who are too ugly, poor, disabled. And
damn.
Kind of, yeah.
That sounds about right for China. China, you have to look. You got to admire China for its savagery. They do not give a fuck. China gives zero fucks. They don't give a fuck, son. They give a fuck less. They're like, nah, we don't want no uglies.
Yeah, that's policy.
Here we pretend like we give a fuck, but we don't. But there, they just, nah, we're like, nah, we're not giving no fucks. No ugly motherfuckers are on here. We work too damn hard to let an ugly motherfucker on the front page.
And I do have TikTok on
your
my
fat, ugly face.
And I have noticed that when I pull it up, all these like little hot ladies are out there dancing for like 3 seconds or so, and they're all just exclusively hot. It's just, well, I mean, they're...
And that brings you back to TikTok, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because you're lonely man. They know what the fuck they're doing, dog. They know what they're doing. All that virtue signaling ain't going to get you nowhere. Nobody wants to look at that shit. I'm not even into like opening up my phone and seeing a bunch of hot fucking ladies. Like, I just want to see like funny shit on Instagram or something like that, something thought provoking or funny. But if I got a choice between that and like some fucking fat ugly motherfucker, guess what I'm picking? I'm picking pretty over fat ugly. They know us as humans. They know us. They studied us. China ain't shit, bro. China ain't shit. They did this too. I'm still mad at China. I'm mad that I'm sitting up in the crib because of China's ass. Whole ass shit.
Oh. I think you can point the finger in many directions for this.
They kind of buried this for a long ass time there, champ. Come on there, John. Come on, John. It's been proven. It's come out that they were a bit slow on telling everybody about their fucking problems, and they're still lying about how many people are dying.
I've read a few things.
Yeah, have you?
Just try to keep on top.
It's not China. Oh no, there's someone else I'm mad at. Like, nah, it's China, bro. It's fucking China. They ain't shit. Fuck them. Chinese people, cool. Chinese government, fuck them.
That's all
I got to say. Not so cool. And I don't understand. And we're just willingly lining up to fucking turn our power over to this group of people that just doesn't like us. They don't fuck with us, bro. They like them more than they like us. And I'm not mad at that.
Hey, they've got the eye of the tiger.
They getting it too, bro. They building islands. They don't give a fuck, son. They're like, oh, this is a cool piece of fucking... real estate here on the water. Be dope if we just built an island right here and controlled it, and then they do it. And they do it with TikTok to do with all that shit, bro.
Now, of course, someone working for TikTok is saying, hey, this is not something we're really doing. That was just some document that we were contemplating. But
yeah, okay.
Every time I go there, it's really just the hot ladies just dancing around for me. So
yeah.
Something's
yeah.
going on. I mean,
nah. China's like the fucking is like your crackhead cousin. You know what I mean? Like you could just count on China to be China. Like I can just count on China to fucking lie. You know. Like you can count on your cousin, like he'll steal your television if you leave him in the house by himself, you know? Like that's the one thing you can count on China for. They'll fucking lie. They're a lying ass underhanded country.
They would view it differently, but yeah.
Yeah, to you, but deep down he's like, yeah, he right. He's on to us. Let's smear him. Let's smear this motherfucker.
And by the way, I have read that little TikTok app is really just a vacuum on your phone. So if you do have it on there, you may want to rethink that.
What do you mean it's a vacuum? They take all of your shit?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty impressive when it sucks up information that you're doing.
Yeah, so I don't have it. It's bad enough I got other shit that's sucking up all my stuff. But like this, and it's getting indirectly sold to China. This is like straight to China. So I'm like, nah, that's where I draw the line. One could argue that my Instagram is doing the same thing, and it probably is. But this one is right there. There's no middleman. So I'm just like, nah, I'm good on you. But they do come up with some wacky little videos. I ain't gonna lie. I've reposted some funny TikToks. Hey, we're back. It's our first day back. Doing it from the apartment. Good to be back.
And so, speaking of everyone being at home, it looks like people are now out there drinking a lot of alcohol. Alcoholic beverage sales shot up 55%. In the third week of March compared to the same time a year ago.
You know what I think is bullshit? They found that like alcohol, like liquor stores are essential, but cigarette stores are not essential. Don't you find that kind of bullshit? Like, but like, why is someone's alcohol addiction more essential than someone's cigarette addiction?
Well, it's more socially acceptable. I have to go hang out by the dumpster to smoke a cigarette, but, you know, I can go to a bar.
Yeah, but you're in your house. Wasted. You can smoke in your fucking crib. You know what I mean? You want to smoke? You're fucking stressed out. You're addicted to cigarettes. Like, I went to go buy the cigarette shop just to grab some shit that wasn't cigarettes, and it was closed. I'm like, huh, that's funny. Liquor store is open. Cigarette store is not. I guess you got to go to 7-Eleven for your shit.
That is a fact.
I don't know. I just find that the what's essential and what's not essential. We're technically essential, but you and I are broadcasting from our apartments. So go figure.
We are critical.
Go figure. And they're like, put on a happy face for them. It's like, put on a happy fucking face. I'm broadcasting from my goddamn apartment. I can't even leave here.
Did you shower today?
Yeah, I took a fucking shower. I was just like, nice. Let me take a... I'm sitting in a robe. I didn't get dressed. I was just like, all right, man, let me take a shower so that I can at least be a semi-not piece of shit and fucking do this goddamn show. So here you go. We are back. We're back in effect. It's good to be here. Woo. Give me another news story.
All right. So here in Los Angeles, I was a little surprised by this, but the mayor yesterday, he suggested that people wear masks outside. I've always sort of scoffed at this, but now that's become policy where they're saying, you know, you don't want to go out there and get your fancy sort of medical grade mask, but if you have one that you've made at home, perhaps from a scarf or something,
such bullshit.
Are you gonna wear your mask? You've got masks.
They show not to work, dude. They show not to work. It's just bullshit. I saw some fucking guy driving in an Audi by himself with a mask on. Like, who are you gonna contaminate, bro? Like, you're driving in your Audi with the windows up by yourself. Who are you going to contaminate? Yourself? You fucking moron? Fuck Eric Garcetti. That's the mayor. He also encouraged people to snitch on one another. He's like, if you see people, he's like, snitches. The saying is snitches get stitches, but snitches get rewards. Like, he straight up wants you to tell on your fellow citizens for fucking, I don't know, what, walking around without a mask?
That, maybe, yeah. Playing
having
basketball
the
at the park.
Open, some shit like that. Like, really, dog? Like, this is getting a little crazy, man. Man, fuck Eric Garcetti.
Oh, he's looking out for us.
Is he? He wasn't looking. We've been having a disease problem for a minute here with all those goddamn bums. He ain't do a fucking thing. While the bubonic plague was creeping in, now he's worried about it. I'm gonna start telling every time I see a fucking bum outside, I'm like, hey, boop, over here at motherfucking Hollywood and Normandy. There's some people out here without masks on, stick fighting, yelling at the air. You might want to come check that out. Oh, they're homeless people. They don't matter. Okay. This has just become ridiculous, dog. This has become ridiculous. So fucking nuts.
You know, I mean, since I'm still outside smoking, the homeless people still come up to me and ask for cigarettes. I'm just like, oh, come on. Please, stay back. I mean, the idea that I'm like suddenly like hand my pack to them. Here, take a couple.
Yeah, and lick the pack, too, while you're at it, fucking homeless guy. Like, get the fuck gone, dude. Yeah, Garcetti literally told people to tell on each other. This is turning really like 1984 shit. Like, I've been saying that, but like it keeps ratcheting up. It's like one little step at a time. Let's see what we can get away with. Now he's encouraging citizens to tell on one another for what? Walking outside without a mask, running a business.
So I'm guessing you will not be wearing a mask later today.
I got a bunch of masks that are bullshit. They're made out of goddamn, they're about as thick as Kleenex. They're bullshit as hell. I literally fucking tongue fucked a hole through the goddamn mask the other day. I was on my IG live. I was like, look at this mask, blah, 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 blah. And like fucking
nice.
And in 30 seconds I was able to bust a hole through the mask. Like, that's gonna stop some shit? Like, give me a fucking break. We still don't experts keep changing. They keep changing the parameters and of this disease. Like, they still don't know what the fuck is going on. They're still learning. They're like, oh, you got to do this. Oh, you got to do that. Oh, you got to do this. Oh, you got to do that. Oh, wash your hands. Oh, that really doesn't do anything. You know, it's just like, people just want answers. They want someone to tell them what to do so that they can feel secure. So they're not, now it's fucking, what's going to happen if I don't have my mask on out in Los Angeles?
Nothing. It's just, it's encouraged. They're just saying that they revised their position on that, and that if you've got a mask, you might as well wear it. Can't hurt.
They roll up, excuse me, sir, where's your mask? And I'm like walking next to some guy that's shitting on the side of the street, and they're going to ask me where my mask is. I'm like, It's at Bob's Mask Warehouse. And it's hard to get a fucking mask.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's why they're saying you should make one at home. Get your cloth mask.
Yeah, make yourself a... Get a bandana. Be like a gang member.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Fucking ridiculous. You could tell I find this whole thing ridiculous. I'm just like so annoyed by this whole fucking ordeal. I'm so annoyed by it.
Well, I do have some good news for you.
All right, give me some good news.
And now, time for good news.
All right, so I've got a New York teacher's love of boxing. This has inspired her to launch a class for young people who are on the autism spectrum. Her name is Jessica Margulies. And she's been boxing for a bit to deal with stress, and it's good, man.
When is she going to start the class? They're not allowed to have the... Well, can't nobody be in the class together. When's she going to start the class, John?
Well, things were rolling a couple weeks ago, but she's out of New York, and it'll be back soon. You want to hear her talk for a second about her boxing?
Oh, my God. This is your good news? Some classes they can't even run because of the fucking coronavirus?
Hey, I've been shadow boxing out in the parking lot.
Because of Wuhan shit? Get the fuck out of here, man. Yo, and here's the other thing. Like, real talk, like, my ex was like in this boxing class, and she got put into the ring with this dude that had autism, and he was like bigger than her, and he beat the shit out of her.
Yeah.
Cause he's got autism. He doesn't understand like not going all the way. So he just like, she got beat up by like this man, and she was looked at the boxing teacher like, dog, what the fuck are you doing, man? Like, why do you have me in the ring with this dude that is autistic? He doesn't understand like his own fucking strength. And the guy's all stoked because he thinks he's doing a good job because he just beat the shit out of this fucking 110-pound woman. But yeah. So is it autistic people beating up each other, or are they beating up like regular cats, or how's that go?
Well, I mean, from what I can tell, she's simply just training him, and then they're like following the rules. You know, one, two, three, hook, and stuff like that.
Oh, so, yeah. Oh, so they're not getting in the ring with one another?
I mean, they're probably sparring a bit, but I just have you talking about it for a second. You want to hear
all
it for
right,
a
let's
second?
Hear it. Yeah.
All right, here we go.
I felt confident, strong, and it hit me. This would be such a great feeling for children with special needs to feel. And there's something really structured about boxing. I hit, you hit. I follow a sequence, one, two, three. Children who are on the spectrum love structure. Some kids that could not be coordinated in anything else, parents had told me, as soon as they put on the boxing gloves, it just clicked.
See, so they're out there following the rules, beating up your friend.
There you go. She's making sweeping generalizations about autistic people.
You're a boxer. What do you want?
I'm just playing. That's cool. She's doing something for the kids. That's good. But you got, if you, just from my own personal anecdotal experience, you got to really watch these kids very closely because they get in the ring, they don't know their own strengths, and they'll beat the shit out of each other. So you got to watch out. That's all I got to say. Make sure they're evenly matched.
Got it.
They don't understand halfway. Generally speaking. So that was good.
It is.
Hey, guess what? That's the news.